you guys? Marty Schwartz here with GuitarJams.com. We've got a special guest in the Guitar Jam studio today. His name's John Kineski.
Thanks for being here.
And
thanks for having me.
That's an awesome guitar, and the riff sounded rad. You're here. You're going to teach Cashmere, right?
Yeah, we're going to do Cashmere.
Dude, I'm really stoked about that. So thank you. Oh, and it's in a weird tuning, right?
Yeah. The first thing you got to do is you got to go into Dadgad for this. It's Dadgad is just D, A, D, G, A, D.
And
easy to remember.
You know, there's online tuners out there.
Yeah.
That costs a little bit of money, but I actually have a free tuner.
Oh, cool.
So if people need to get into that tuning, it's a common tuning.
Yeah.
I'm going to leave a link for that free tuner, tuner app. So that'll be sick.
Yeah. Never be afraid to twist the knobs and tune the guitar differently.
That is true.
Cool. So the first thing you got to do is make sure you're in Dadgad. Basically just you drop your E down to a D, your A remains an A. D remains a D. G is a G. Take your B, drop it down to an A, and your E, and down to a D. So, you get this. And now, what that is it's an open D suspended fourth chord when you strum it. For those that care.
It's expensive sounding.
Yeah, it sounds expensive. Okay, so our first formation here, we're just going to teach the very first riff here first. So, it goes like this. I'll play it slowly. Simple enough. Your pinky remains in this spot here, the fifth fret on the fifth string, throughout the whole riff. And then the only thing that moves is this top note here, which is on the G string. It starts on the second fret. And it just moves up chromatic. The third fret. Fourth fret. And, you might want to switch your pinky to your third finger here, whatever is comfortable for your hand position. Then go to the fourth fret. And then the final position is the seventh fret on the third string. And then that's the top one. So, all together. And that's it.
So what you were gonna say something about like the time signature?
Yeah.
The timing of it?
So the timing on this riff is it's kind of confusing, but basically the cool thing and the genius of it is that the guitar riff itself is in 3/4 time. So 1 2 3 1 2 3 but the drums are just in a 2/4. And they work together. So it's 3/4 time, but it's 9 bars of 3.
Uh-huh.
So
yeah, and that makes it interesting.
It makes it genius.
Makes it very interesting, doesn't it?
Yeah. Cool. The really cool, like, fun part to go to. And there's a million horns, I think, and stuff going on in the original recording.
A lot of layering.
Yeah. So
you know about that, right?
Totally. Okay, so the next part is just, it's this part. And it's a really simple, just a pattern here. So you want to be on the 12th fret, the first string, with your third finger. 12th fret on the third string with your second finger. And then all you do is just drop that thing on the third string down a half step. So from 12 to 11. It does that same little half step pattern. It does that same half step pattern on the third string every time it goes down. So, and it goes down. Same figure on the 10th fret, so 10 and 10. But drop your 10 down to 9 on the third string. Then 7th fret, 7 and 7. Drop your 7th fret on the 3rd string, down to 6th. 5th fret, 5 and 5. Drop that down to the 4th fret. 3rd fret, 3rd fret, drop it down to 2nd. And then 3rd fret, 2nd fret, open on the 4th string, or D string. That's
awesome.
It. Cool. Okay, so we're going to show you the bridge here. That would be this part, that cool little breakdown thing. It's like... yeah, so it's pretty simple. It looks a lot like an A power chord that you would already probably know. So... And it's this kind of figure up here. Now what I'm doing here is I got my 2nd finger on the 12th fret on the 5th string, the 11th fret on the 4th string, and the 12th fret on the 2nd string, and those are the only three that I'm playing. So I'm using my 1st finger to mute this unwanted G in the middle here. And you also might want to mute that low D string too, which I just accidentally hit. So. And then a cool little turnaround riff here is this cool thing. So it's just 3-2-0 on the 4th string, then open hammer-on on the 2nd fret, and then open D string.
Hey, dude, that was an awesome lesson, man.
Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, good test.
I really appreciate you coming by and teaching that lesson. Also, I'm going to leave a link that can take people to somewhere very special that has to do with you.